sit like this. Close your eyes. Whatever you see in your imagination is God showing you what you need to know. Lots of twirling around of things, spirals and sort of fractured things, wheels turning, there's a planet in the middle spinning, that sort of stuff. And it looks like a ceiling and a floor going on for ages, like in parallel to each other. And falling. Scooby-Doo characters. The bloke and the orange-haired girl running. Mummy. I'm scared of a mummy. I had some thoughts earlier that I've got a spirit attachment, like a mummified pharaoh or something, that may be simultaneously attaching in thousands, hundreds of thousands, millions maybe, of people. And he seems really hard to shift, really patient, doesn't put up a fight but just sits there like a rock. You can't get rid of them because there's some sort of emotion we haven't felt. And I want to feel it, God. I want to feel it. I'm starting to feel the face pulling above my eye to the right hand side, and in my eyes but I'll concentrate on that and feel that more. And ask to feel that stronger. I'm getting fears of suffocation, darkness, blindness. That's how he got into me. I don't know. I had conjunctivitis when I was a boy a few times. Maybe that, partly that blindness, not having faith, losing my faith maybe a bit. And I was told I wasn't allowed to cry. I shouldn't cry. Blackmailed with chocolate. Yeah. Don't cry, I'll give you chocolate. An addiction set in. I do quite a lot to climb up to get the Saturday box with the chocolates in. That would be a little challenge. The rebellious streak in me, that's where I had to get my love from. The road, that was the entry point to addiction. Doing that for God's love. An addiction allowed in spirit connection. I don't know. I'm going back to try and feeling. I may not talk for a while. My right leg's going numb and weird sort of thing going up the shin. Wow, this is the first time I've done it in this position, and it's like it's all over your body rather than just in your face or anything. I feel like a little crouching mouse, which feels suitable. Like I'm vulnerable and afraid. I don't have faith in God. That God would provide for me and protect me. And my head's off a bit to the side, but feels a little more so. In a way, I think I know what's coming next, which is probably stopping it, because it's probably not what I think. Just look at what I see in my imagination and go with that. You know what I mean by imagination? Like, you can close your eyes and sometimes you just see swirly bits, but you can paint pictures if you want. You know, just whatever comes to mind. And for most of you, there'll be obscene things because you've got to go through that stuff and then ask why. Why did I see that obscene, horrible thing? You know, what's wrong with me that you would show me that, in a sense, in the presence of God, which you always are. You're always in the presence of God. It's just, we shut the doors to it. And cannabis seems to pull off these layers and open these doors. And then you can see for what it really is. Otherwise, you're never going to bother to do it, are you? You're never going to just sit there and close your eyes. You're just not going to do it. Too much fear stop you from doing it. You have to get the truth first. Once you've sat on the truth for a while and you've got them settled in and you're seeing everything in a new way, then you can sit here and do this with cannabis, because it'll open you up. Currently you smoke cannabis and something scares you, it means because you've got a distruth, a misbelief sitting with you. I hope you can understand what I'm saying. I know I'm blurring in a bit. I'm going to stop talking because I've got to feel. Look and feel. Try not to sort of see too much, just what's in the mind's eye. I was just checking the battery because I thought this could take a while. Don't worry about your legs and stuff going numb. Right, I'll try and get into it. I won't try, that's the thing. You can't try and do it. I haven't always sat like this. I did say it's the first time I sat like this. I tell you what. I think I'll just take a little break. That was my problem. I thought I knew what was going to happen next. It's always different. It's never the same.